Hello and welcome. During the iterative procedure to calculate the solution for the defined CFD problem, the Ansys Fluent solver must perform enough iterations and satisfy multiple conditions, often referred to as convergence conditions, to ensure that the solution is converged, after which the simulation can be called done. Monitoring convergence in Ansys Fluent, that is, verifying that the equations are satisfactorily solved, can be done in multiple ways, one of which is by calculating and analyzing residual plots, which can be accessed from the Reports group of the Solution tab. In this lesson, we will learn what residuals are and how to plot and analyze the residual plots for monitoring convergence. Let's get started. So, what are residuals? Residuals are the imbalances between the left-hand side and the right-hand side of the discrete equations solved by Ansys Fluent, summed over all cells in the domain. When these imbalances decrease below certain criteria, called convergence criteria, the equations are considered to be sufficiently solved. It is a standard practice to iterate until the residuals for every equation are below the convergence criteria. Strictly speaking, there are no universal metrics for judging convergence. However, if a steady solution fulfills these three conditions, which are residual values drop below a specified criterion, the overall balances for all equations, mass, momentum, energy, etc., are fulfilled, and the solution variables no longer change if additional iterations are performed, the solution can be considered to be satisfactorily converged. The focus of this video lesson is the first condition, that is, residuals dropping below the specified criteria. Now that we know what residuals are, let's learn about the different options available for setting the convergence criteria for the equations solved by Ansys Fluent through an example. Launch Ansys Fluent in solution mode and read in the provided case file. Let us directly proceed to the solution tab since all the required upstream steps have already been performed. One of the groups in the Solution tab is the Reports group, which allows us to define the settings for the residual monitors in addition to creating report definitions and setting their convergence conditions. Click on Residuals button here to open the Residual Monitors dialog box. In the Residual Monitors dialog box, the default absolute convergence criterion for each equation that is solved is listed next to them. For most cases, these default values are sufficient as they provide enough time for the solution to establish to a steady state. However, there can be situations where tighter convergence may be required, that is, lower values of absolute criteria. For such cases, the values of absolute criteria can be changed directly for any or all the equations as required. Additionally, you can even disable monitoring of residuals or disable convergence checks for one or more equations to stop Ansys Fluent from computing residuals and verifying the convergence criterion for them, respectively. By default, residual values for all the solved equations are printed to the console after each iteration. This can be turned off by disabling Print to Console under Options. In addition to printing, the residual values are also plotted in the graphics window during the calculation by default, as they vary with iteration number. The number of residual history points that are plotted to the screen can be modified, if required, by varying the iterations to plot option. Furthermore, you even have the option to change the line style, marker style of the residual plots by accessing the curves and axis menus. The display of residual plots to screen during simulation runtime can be disabled by turning off the plot setting under Options. Note that the residuals plot can be displayed to the screen on demand by simply accessing this panel after pausing the simulation and clicking the plot button at the bottom. Residual histories for each equation are automatically saved to the data file when written, regardless of whether they are being monitored. We can control the number of history points to be stored by changing the iterations to store entry. The maximum limit is 1000 iterations. Advanced settings, including the option for normalizing, scaling, or computing local scale, and many more, can be accessed by enabling the Show Advanced Options setting. For more details on these advanced options, please refer to the Ansys Fluent user guide. The default absolute convergence criteria are robust and can be used for most of the CFD simulation problems, and for our example, we will leave all the options to their default values and click OK. Now that we know what residuals are and the different options available under residual monitors, let's see now how the residuals plot looks like during the simulation. First, click on Initialize and then click on Run Calculation to calculate the solution for 200 iterations. We can see the residuals plot in the Scaled Residuals window in the Graphics window here. Once all residuals fall below the absolute convergence criteria, we can say the solution has converged, and a message confirming the same can be seen down here in the console. Let's summarize what we have learned in this video. We learned that residuals are the imbalances between the left and the right hand side of the discrete equations that Ansys Fluent solves and their importance in monitoring convergence. We talked about different settings under the residual monitor dialog box, and we established that these settings don't need to change that often, as default settings provided by Ansys Fluent are applicable for most simulation problems. We then solved the case by running it and understood how the residuals are plotted during the simulation, and how the simulation is automatically stopped by Ansys Fluent for meeting the defined convergence criteria. With this, we have come to the end of our video. Thank you very much for watching.